The film tracks Nancy's story beginning with her days as a teenage rock and roll star, played by actress Amy Jo Johnson.
Did you hear that, Mom? We got a record deal. We're going to go and we're going to record an album.
It absolutely is the hardest role I've ever had to play that has been in front of me. She goes through so many highs and lows, and it has a lot of tragedy happen to her, and then at the same time a lot of really great stuff, and it's just such a diverse character, and I'm having a blast doing it.
Amy Jo knows something about teen stardom, playing Julie Emmerich on the TV show Felicity, and the pink Power Ranger in the popular film and TV series.
You obviously don't know who you're dealing with, Mr. Raisinhead.
Really?
Not only can Amy Jo act, she can also sing. She even wrote an original song for the film called First Love.
While the glass is sifting sand.
I really feel like this whole role has been like a gift from God, you know what I mean? Because I'm a singer and an actress, and I get to do both in a movie. They used all the original tracks from, like, you know, 68, 69 of the music. And then I went in and recorded the vocals on top of it, which was so fun.
They use the old tracks, so you have that Sweetwater spirit there. And they put her voice in, and she's doing it. She's pulling it off.
If I can't count on you, baby, better than you know what I might do.
But they've done a fine job. She did a fine job. I think she sounds great.
For Nancy, there were moments during the filming that brought back memories.
They were doing a meeting between Janice and Nancy, myself, and I remember that. Janice frightened me a little bit. She was big, and she was edgy, and she was a party girl, and she laughed. You know that great laugh. How are you, honey?
Hey, I got my eye on you, girl. You messing with her trip?
Me? No.
Don't. I got my eye on you, too. Keep the faith, kiddo. The only thing they can't take away from you.
Michelle Phillips of the Mamas and the Papas was cast as Nancy Nevins today.
They were inspiration to everybody. We were a little bit after them, you know, and so, but yeah, you always watch them, and they were wonderful. Great group.
My relationship to music was completely different. I understood her ambition to become a singer, and then her need to turn her back on it too. I remember very well the joys of being a musical star. It was exhilarating. So there are some obvious parallels in our relationship.
It was rock and roll, right? Booze, drugs, live for today. It was crazy. I could have killed myself, but I just didn't care.
First of all, I think she's beautiful, just beautiful, and I've admired her work in the years.
For her role, Michelle decided to leave the singing to Nancy.
So now she's going to be doing the lip syncing to my actual voice now, which is different, of course, from the voice I had before the accident.
Actors were hired who knew and understood the music business, like Phillips and 80s punk rocker Adam Ant, who plays producer Todd Badham.
Do any of you honestly think that you'd be here about to go on national TV if it wasn't for Nancy? Nancy's the one they come to see.
There are a number of musical-based scripts that come along, and a lot of them don't actually ring very true. I think this one was interesting, the way it's shot in flashback, and the fact that it's about a band that sort of was about to make it but didn't for, you know, a tragic reason. I thought very accurately written. That appealed to me.
The cast also includes film veteran Fred Forrest, who's appeared in Apocalypse Now and Tucker, The Man and His Dream. Fred plays Sweetwater keyboardist Alex Del Zoppo.
I think it's a great story, you know. It's a very poignant, very
I mean, anything you say would be, to me, would be inadequate, be trite. It's sad, it's powerful. I mean, to be that close to stardom and then to have a terrible accident like that, you know, and what could be worse?
The whole country was digging us. We were flying all over, doing 4 or 5 shows a week to packed houses.
Watching my life being played out on film is both cathartic and disturbing. I mean, it really brought back a lot of old emotions. I mean, it was done so well that it really got to me. We really got cut short in our prime, and just watching it unfold on the screen is just like, well, finally, you know.
Here's Amy Jo Johnson singing to the original track of a classic Sweetwater tune, In a Rainbow.
She didn't leave town with 6 men in a broken down truck.
Some going through me, not telling me why. Some slow and some fast, and some teaching me how to fly. I'm not too sure now, but I'm in a rainbow.
Brad, can you believe that?
Welcome to Woodstock, brother.
Do our own music, our own way. We are not going to be turned into your backup band.
You're the one. You're the star.
If you're asking if your voice will be the same, the answer is no.
Coming up, the lost years after Sweetwater broke up and Nancy Nevin's darkest days.
I followed a pattern of drinking and using that made me hit a hard bottom.
Plus, an emotional return to the band's old stomping grounds. VH1's Behind the Movie Sweetwater continues.
The first band to play at Woodstock.
Sweetwater is going to be the next big thing.
Then they disappear.
If you're asking me if your voice will be the same, the answer is no.
You cannot cut an album without me.
Sweetwater, a true rock story, starring Amy Jo Johnson, Kelly Williams, and Michelle Phillips.
I was supposed to be a star.
Premiere Sunday at 9, 8 Central. VH1 Originals, movies that rock.
Nancy Nevins and the rest of Sweetwater's rock and roll dreams were dashed in an ugly car crash on the night of December 8, 1969. By the time production began in early 1999 on the VH1 original movie, a lot had changed. Drummer and original Sweetwater member Alan Milarowicz died in a car wreck in 1981. Shortly after that, cellist August Burns died from injuries suffered when a cable snapped in an elevator he was riding. And in 1994, flautist Albert Moore died of lung cancer. After Sweetwater broke up, Nancy's attempt at a solo career failed. She went through years of musical and financial struggle. In the 80s, Nancy went back to school and graduated with a master's in English. Today, she teaches English at Glendale College in Southern California. But she's spending more and more time trying to revive Sweetwater.
I think we're a little bit different from, you know, a group making a comeback that already made it once and had a hit record. We're like the almost people. We're almost. We're there, you know? There's still a lot of happiness ahead for us and a lot of musical discoveries that we can make together.
28 years after the release of their last album, Melon, Sweetwater started playing again. Joining Nancy is original keyboardist Alex Del Zoppo, who works as a construction foreman in Southern California and also teaches master classes in songwriting, and bassist Fred Herrera, who's kept his hand in music working as a composer, arranger, and producer for artists such as Yanni and Michael Crawford. In 1999, Sweetwater released Cycles, which features remastered old tracks and new original music. Nancy was on the movie set as the filmmakers recreated Sweetwater's 30th reunion at L.A.'s Whiskey A Go-Go. She took the stage and did an impromptu version of Motherless Child. The performance took Nancy back to the old days, when Sweetwater would play the whiskey, long before that fateful night when one person's life and the band's future nearly ended. Sweetwater, a true rock story, premieres on VH1 Sunday, August 15th at 9 p.m., 8 Central.
Sometimes I feel.
I'm not sure that that many people ever get this kind of an opportunity, you know, to pick up a dream again. And I'm a la la la.